Hello guys, welcome back to This Is The Police. We'll pick up where we left off in the last episode. We already read the headlines, so let's go to work. It looks like Birch has something to say to us. My father got drunk and beat my mother again. This time it looks pretty bad. I'd like to go to them. Can I have the day off? And we can say yes, or yes but come tomorrow, or no. Well, that does sound pretty bad. So I guess he can have the day off, indeed. Go to them. And we got a couple of badges here. Two of those. I'm not sure what that does. We can click and drag them. So I guess we can promote someone. So let's promote the two best cops on shift A, Storrel and Robbins. Actually, let's promote Robbins first and see if his stats increases by receiving this honor. Yeah, it did. So he's up to 200, so we might spend it somewhere else. So maybe we could give it to Roy so he's not useless, even though it feels pretty awkward giving him a medal for being useless. We could also just push Samadhi over the less than average cop up to being a good cop. If it's 50 points, that'll just put him over the average of 150. So maybe we should give it to him. There we go. So now we have 3 good cops and 4 pretty bad cops. And these two. So let's start the day. Choose a song to play. That's new. This looks pretty interesting. Green Little Boogeyman. Or... it's hard to select these. This looks like a piano. That might be some jazzy stuff. Let's play that. Bud meets Bob. Bud Freeman. From G-Tunes. Yeah. We'll play that. And we have our first call. Vandalism at St. John's Cathedral. That's pretty nice looking, and right here by the river. Received a frightening call from the local cathedral. This morning the abbot discovered that someone entered the old cemetery during the night. The old yard's tombstones are painted with satanic symbols, and some have been broken into pieces. It seems there are even marks from a shovel, but the abbot would say no more. And this is a fairly easy event, we can only send 2 cops. So I think we'll stick with sending an ace cop and a pretty useless stooge of a cop. So Stovall and Roy, you're up. Let's go. So why is it saying 2 at the police station? There's something here. Labor market. So it looks like we can hire these guys. He's the best one available. Let's just click on him. Okay, so we can in fact hire. I'm not sure if we'll spend our own money up here or not. But let's hire him if we actually need it, because we have too few people. Let's take this next call. Vandalism, Atticus Tower. Businessman Harley Jones, looking out his window, saw 2 teenagers scratching offensive slogans on his new car. Yeah, that sucks. So let's do the same strategy. Robbins and Birch. Let's go. So we already have 2 sets of guys out, so we might actually need to hire someone else. I don't know if you hire them permanently or just for this shift here. So the first report, and we caught the offender. All is well and good, and Roy increased a little bit. So we have a new call here. Suspicious individual, Eddie's Burgers. A waitress named Myla reports that she's just served Chicken Eddie and a Diet Coke to a dangerous criminal who she's seen on television this morning. The culprit is sitting at the window eating a burger. So there's not much of a choice here. You can send Samadhi and Grant, and now I'm pretty happy that we gave him a stripe there, so he got over the 150. That's an average cop. So now he's a little bit better. So maybe this will work out. So let's send those guys. And I think we need to hire, because we probably run out of cops in a little bit. So let's hire this guy if we can. And we're on shift A right now, so let's hire him for shift A. So now we have all of the cop slots filled out. We have detective slots. We can hire one more detective. So we'll just hire the best one here. We'll hire him for shift A as well. So now everything's filled out. But could we do anything else at the police station? We have personnel, labor market, backlog, no messages. So it doesn't look like our new hire will come in until the next day after this. So now Storval and Roy are back. So if you get another call, it's no problem. So we've got two reports. False alarm. The waitress had mistaken retired officer Frank Nero for the fugitive in question. So that didn't pan out. We have another report at the vandalism at the Atticus Tower. Offender escaped, officers unharmed, but they lost some competency, so that's really bad. What is this over here? Sam Sorkin, King Louis nightclub. Mr. Boyd, my bouncer stuffed himself with Mexican food again, and now he can't get off the can. Meantime, the line outside the club is stretching around the block. We need someone outside who can tell the cool guys from the punks. This might be an opportunity for us to make money, because that doesn't sound like cop stuff. So we'll send our worst cop over there. Maybe he can make us some money that we can put in our retirement fund under the board. So now we're just waiting to see what else will happen this night. And he's making his way over to the nightclub. Here's another call. Drug sales, Christopher G, Sands, Ice Arena. An anonymous call just came in. A clown carrying balloons at the skating ring is selling crack to teenagers. So we have a crack dealer. I think we'll send our best cop and Roy. That's a good team. So off they go. And here's a report from Sam Sorkin. Sorry, Chief, but I quit. In one night, I pulled in more cash than I earned in a month working at this dump. Mr. Sorkin said he wouldn't mind taking me on. I guess I just wasn't cut out to be a cop. Yeah, but we did make money under the table. So we put that in our retirement fund, and our goal is to hit 500,000. So he quit the job as a police officer. It doesn't matter much. He's only a 10. So goodbye, Birds Jr. Go be a bouncer. So we got this thank you of 4,500. Of dirty money, and we're taking that. Click this. Suicide threat, Fleet Street. A naked man carrying a canister of gasoline has threatened to set himself on fire unless his favorite chewing gum becomes popular again. It doesn't sound that dangerous, really. Maybe we should just send one cop to try and talk him off setting fire to the gasoline. Let's send somebody. That's it. And we have a new option here at the police station. That's because we have a cop slot that opened up. So now we can hire another cop. We'll hire the best one here. And they can, in fact, have stuff that we don't see, traits like alcoholism or something like that. But we are just gonna hire the best one because we can't see anything else. So we'll hire him for shift A. So that's where we lost a cop. And we'll continue the day. We have a situation at the drug sales, something we need to attend to and make a decision. As police arrive, a clown is seen making balloon animals for the kids. Okay, so we can take the clown into the ice and round up any witnesses, or we can cover up in a raincoat and pretend to be an illicit customer, or we can carefully watch the clown from the stands. I think we'll just observe for now. So we caught the offender. And the officers gained some competency, so that was the right choice. Here's the report for the suicide threat. We sent somebody. Offender escaped, officer unharmed, so we should have sent one more guy. So let's end the day. I think we did okay. We traded Birds Jr. for a much better cop and made some money into a pension retirement fund of dirty money. So let's just end the day. So now we are day 4. Rob Spears to reveal his identity when the time is right. Feminist organization denied official registration. Enemies using feminists to destroy Freiburg. Very useful headlines. We're used to that from the general press. Let's go to work.
Whenever I'm alone at home and there's a knock at the door, I always hope it'll be my wife, Laura. She's always forgetting her keys.
Hello, my name is Steve, and you're Jack Boyd, is that right?
To get to my front door, the Bible boys walked about a mile from the local bus stop, jumping over mud puddles and skirting a couple of landfills. Laura doesn't go in for religion either, but according to her, these brave lunatics with their fake smiles deserve at least a minute of attention. She patiently listens to them, asks them questions, regales them with pastries, and never once dropping a hint of condescension. When I watch her do it, I've got to admit it gets me. I'd have hugged those boys, sat with them on the porch and lit up a cigar. But a month after Laura left, all I could do was quietly ask them not to bother me. Today I'm a little rougher still. Shut the door on his nose this time. Another couple weeks at this rate and I'll be greeting anyone who comes close with my service pistol pointed towards the sky, ready to fire my warning shots. In my life, even the basic stuff never goes like it's supposed to. Normally, when a wife is going to leave home, she'll make a scene or at least sit everyone down for a serious conversation. But Laura just disappeared. The children in the stories always stand on the side of the mother, but all three of our sons supported me. The in-laws always blame the husband for making their daughter unhappy. But now Sally, Laura's mother, well, we sort of have a pact. The fellow Laura ran off with is young enough to be her son. I hear he's 30 years old. Of all the possible information a man can know about his wife's lover, I get hit with that. Fortunately, Laura's mother doesn't like the way it sounds either. Sally figures this guy just thought he'd have some fun with a mature woman, but he'll be back chasing college girls before the year is out. So we have an agreement. Sally's gonna track down Laura and try to reason with her, and we'll arrange a meeting. Meanwhile, I'm supposed to not do anything stupid, which of course means anything at all. It's a crazy situation. I'm the police chief, and the person I'm trusting to find my wife is an old woman armed with a phone book. But I can't afford to lose Sally as an ally. So for the moment, I had to swallow my pride.
Hello?
Mrs. Markham, this is Boyd.
Oh, is there any news?
That's what I wanted to ask you. Have you found anything? An address? Phone number? Have you spoken to her?
Don't worry, Jack. I've narrowed the range to two suspects, or whatever you like to say at your police building.
At my police building, we find people faster than a funny old woman chirping on the phone with my wife's girlfriends.
Oh, you're an old man, Jack. Come to your senses. They'd give us straight odds on the street. But I've got more energy, Jack. Maybe you think I'm a foolish old woman, but I go to my book club, argue with the girls about Byron, and it gives me energy. I talk to my dogs, and it gives me energy. And you have nothing, Jack. You don't even have a hobby. You got no passion. It's why Laura left you.
Let's not go back into that, Sally. Find my wife, and we can discuss my hobbies later. I'm waiting for your call, and my patience is running thin. Laura, if you've stopped loving me, I'll let you go. I can't expect the impossible from you. Just don't let me die out here, okay?
So we have some marital problems and a lot of kids. And our Tsubaki has some problems of her own. Some pipes in my house busted and I need to wait around for the plumber. Can I take the day? This is a little bit less than average cup. Let's say yes, but come tomorrow. I can't have a house or apartment full of water. So we're down one cup already from the start. But we should be okay. Shift B is a better lineup of cups than on shift A, I think. Let's start the day. So now we get to choose the music again. Chopin. I don't even know if I am pronouncing it correctly, but I think it's classical music. Let's play that. It's a nice red record. Yeah, it's classical music. It's a piano. Let's get the first call here. Destruction of property, city hall parking lot. A member of the city's cleaning crew saw an elderly man approaching some expensive cars in the parking lot, carrying a long iron rod. The whole street could hear him shouting, "Bastards, thieves, bloodsuckers." So I think this is a job for... We'll send Purdy and Price. I like to send tag teams. Let's go. I will click this. I don't know what that is. Investigation. Ah, okay, that's what we need the detectives for. Homicide in the ghetto. Black activist Ronnie Moore was found shot outside his home. So we can send Mole, Armstrong or DiBrito. And Mole is our best detective. We'll send her. So that's a different kind of event. And we also still need to use the SWAT team for something. But I guess we need a harder event for that. They don't get out of bed for anything and put on all of that gear. They need something big. So here's another carjacking in the suburb. A gas station surveillance cameras recorded a car that's on the stolen vehicles list. Wow, this is 4 cops. That's a lot. And we have 3 available. So I'm thinking Austin. What about the SWAT team? Come on guys, we need you. we're going to have to send all 3, I think. Or we'll have a problem here. So now we don't have any available cops, but maybe Price and Purdy will come back soon. Let's check out these reports. Destruction of property, offender caught, officers unharmed, so they gained some competency. And here's the homicide investigation. So I wonder what we do here. Eric Graham, a drunk witness, they drove by in a sedan and they shot like a machine gun. I didn't see much. And we have a cigar here. So apparently we're looking at this as Jack Boyd and trying to figure out who did this. Clayton, this is a neighbor. I only heard a few muffled shots. Mr. Carr, it's also a neighbor. He got what he deserved. He's been causing trouble for a long time and recently there's been a lot of cursing and carrying on. Mrs. Cobb, this is a witness. I don't remember the car and the neighborhood was quiet. I never heard any shots. Mr. Carpenter, a neighbor. The police these days don't do nothing. I almost died myself. I went to buy some medicine and was nearly hit by some idiot's car. Let's see. Yeah, it's a black activist. We know that. And sequence. He came out and he got shot. We don't really know much. I think we're not supposed to do anything here right now. So let's close down that and get this report. Fire all black cops from City Hall. A racist gang has recently made some trouble in the city. They're capturing black townspeople and beating them to death. They recently sent a message to a local radio station promising to kill all the black doctors, firemen and police. We don't need any more dead police, especially not mere months before the election. The racists are gaining more and more followers and even some of our citizens support them. You will have to fire all your black employees over the next 2 days due to mounting racial tensions. That's really weird. We only have 1 though, I think, Austin. I wonder what happens if we don't. I guess she'll just leave on her own when the 2 days are up. So here's another call. But first we get this event. Situation, carjacking suburb. The driver is nowhere to be seen, so we can search the car, wait at a safe distance for the driver to appear, or interview any potential eyewitnesses. Well, if it's a carjacking, it's not really safe to assume that he'll be coming back. He might never come back for that car. So let's just search the car, see what we can find. So we caught the offender, and we increased our stats, all well and good. And here's another event. Suspicious individual, Desire Park. Corey Ramsey, mother of several children, has expressed her concerns about a suspicious man wearing bifocals seated on a bench beside a playground. He's been watching the children for over an hour and has taken several photographs of them. So if that's a pedophile, we certainly want to catch that guy, so we'll send 2 cops. So nothing but sirens in the night. Here we have an opportunity to make money. And we also have a report. Let's get the report first. This is the suspicious individual at the playground and record him. That's great. And this one is counting down on the timer. I just wait for some more cops to come back so we have more options. We have everyone back now. So let's see. Kazuki Tamura, Dragon's Lair Club. Mr. Boyd, I'm opening Freeburg's first martial arts club. And for my first exhibition, I want to hold a sparring match where one of my students take on your toughest cop. After the fight, I'll teach your man a few tricks, something that will help him out on the streets. So we can send anyone we want. I'm thinking we'll send Yancy, because everyone else is women. And I'm figuring it's a male fight. So Yancy, you go. So we can make some money for our retirement fund. Let's get this report on the homicide. From Detective Mole, you've got 3 new frames. Okay, open up the investigation. Let's see what you've got. It looks like a drive-by here. This must be a surveillance camera on the street. That's a Glock with a silencer probably. And here's a red pickup truck. And here's a guy with a Uzi in the same car as the silencer. If you click on the images, they'll get enlarged, but other than that, we don't have anything. All of the witnesses and neighbors are the same. So we'll just let her continue the investigation. So we have a fight at Kevin's Throat Bar. A bartender reports that a couple dancers started fighting over tips and a cat fight broke out right on stage. And we can send 3 cops to this event. So let's do that. We'll send our ace cop and our 2 worst cops. What's going on here? It's the same kind of event at Kevin's Throat Bar. A bartender reported that a fight had broken out between a patron and the bar's bouncer. The man, apparently drunk, had climbed onto the stage while a local singer was performing and tried to sing a duet with her. We only have Purdy available. We'll send her. Now we need to get some more cops back before we can do anything else. But Yancy's almost there. So here we have our report. Chief, I just about nailed the jab a couple of times, but he was too fast for me and won on points. I don't really understand all the rules, so I can't keep track of points very well. But he was alright, even showed me a few tricks after the match. I got carried away a little and pulled my back. Think I can take a day off. I don't think we made any money at all, unfortunately, and he pulled his back. I'm not sure, maybe he increased a little bit in competency. So here's the situation at Kevin's Throat Bar. On the stage are 2 strippers going at it, and it's gone beyond arguing to a full-on catfight. The bouncer is fast asleep, clearly too wasted to handle the situation. The drunken patrons are happily watching the fight. So we can draw a service weapon. That seems a little bit overboard for a couple of strippers doing it out on stage. Listen, girls, cut the crap or this is going to get serious. Or we can say shut off the music and turn up the lights. I think that's the way to really get people sensible again. I used to be a bartender, and if you do that, it seems that people wake up and start leaving. So let's shut off the music and turn up the lights. The strippers continue fighting, oblivious of the police presence. She threw a pretty good jab there, I guess. The blonde is winning. Ask the bartender for a bucket of cold water and throw it on the combatants, or watch strippers go at it and don't interfere, or step onto the stage and try to separate the girls. I think we'll just do that. That's the right police work to do. So we caught the offenders and everyone's unharmed. That's good. So here's the report for the fight where we only sent Purdy. The offender escaped, unfortunately, so she loses a little bit of stat. And now we are at the end of the day. So I don't know if we actually solved this investigation. I guess we didn't. Or maybe it'll continue in the next day. I'm not sure. Day 5. We have a retired police officer, Thomas Blaine, shoots pregnant woman. Officer Blaine explains that thought she was a suicide bomber. Mayor Rogers City has no problems with the racists. Alright guys, We'll leave off here for this episode and we'll continue in the next one. Thank you for watching and I'll catch you all next time.